Hi everyone, Pete Werner here with your Diz Daily Fix for January 15th, 2016. Here's what's happening today. Three people have been charged with illegally reselling Disney Park Hopper passes. According to Fox 35 Orlando, Orange County sheriffs arrested the three after they allegedly sold the tickets to undercover investigators and gave them specific instructions on what names to use with the tickets and what to say if they were approached by Disney security. Further investigation by the sheriff's office uncovered that the tickets were sold, which were five-day park hoppers, only had one day left on them. So this is yet another cautionary tale. Don't purchase discount Disney tickets from roadside vendors. You're going to get ripped off. DisneyParks.com announced this morning that the Lights, Motors, Action Extreme Stunt Show and nearby locations at Disney's Hollywood Studios will be closing permanently on April 2nd. This is to make way for the upcoming Toy Story Land and Star Wars Land expansions that were announced last August at the D23 convention in Anaheim. While Disney has not announced an opening date for the new lands, guests can expect this area of the park to be under construction for quite some time. WDWMagic.com is reporting rumors that there might be a new meet-and-greet area under construction at Disney's Hollywood Studios as well. Construction walls are up surrounding the former American Idol audition rooms, the radio studio, and the old corporate lounge. While Disney has not confirmed this, with two recently closed meet-and-greet areas on the Streets of America, the rumor makes sense. Over on the Diz, contributor Dylan Flood writes about the top five pieces of merchandise we'd love to see at Walt Disney World. And over on DizBoards.com, a brand new cruiser has her first Disney cruise coming up in a few months and wants to know what other folks do on their day at sea. If you've got a cruise in your future, check out all these great ideas being offered on the Disney Cruise Line forum. And on the Disney Resorts forum, poster JM McCoy 18 asks what Disney resort you would stay in if money were no object. Weigh in with your choice over at DizBoards.com. On DizUnplugged.com today, our Connecting with Walt podcast continues. Michael Bowling and Craig Williams discuss how Walt Disney's death impacted the creative course of the Walt Disney World project. You can listen to that show over at DizUnplugged.com and also subscribe to that show and all the other Diz Unplugged shows over on iTunes. In the weather forecast, if you're in Orlando this weekend, expect partly cloudy skies on Saturday with a high of 77 and a low of 58. Sunday is going to be rain, and more rain with a high of 66 and a low of 45. Out in Disneyland, expect a much nicer weekend with sunny skies on Saturday and a high of 64 with lows dropping into the 40s. And on Sunday, more sun with a high of 70 and a low of 52. You can find links to these stories and much more over at wdwinfo.com/dailyfix. That's all we have for you today. We'll see you again Monday, noon Eastern, with another installment of the Diz Daily Fix. Have a great weekend, everyone.